Hey guys, Wells Knight here, bringing you another brand new episode of Design Tech, my own custom mod pack. And in today's episode, what we're going to be doing is making use of that Enderman farm, or the end, that we discovered in the last episode. And we're going to be making an Enderman farm over there for Ender Pearls, because right now we've got this guy going right here, but he's taking a pretty fair amount of power. I mean, we're talking, I don't know how much he's using, but he's using quite a lot. And if we can do a more vanilla farm, shall we say, then that would greatly help out our power situation. So that's what we're going to be working on. I want to make a fan. In fact, we're a little bit low on fans. Okay, let's make a bunch of iron bars. I'll just make several stacks of them. I've got more iron than I know what to do with, so it's not a big deal. We'll make, like, that should be plenty of fans, I think. We're going to need some levers. There we go. Made two stacks of those. Let's see, and then we're gonna need some blocks. Let's see what we have. We could just go smooth stone, that might work. Especially if we did like a chiseled version of it. Yeah, why don't we do that? We'll just take a bunch of smooth stone with us. Just a whole bunch. And let's just fill up... Let's fill up the purple backpack with building materials. There we go. That should be more than enough smooth stone. We'll put the fans in there. I'm going to need a whole bunch of hoppers. So let's make two stacks of those. And then we're also going to need... Oh, I don't suppose I have any more nether stars, do I? Okay, I might have to go kill a wither. That wouldn't be that big of a deal, though. We'll need a chunk loader. We will need another tesseract. So let's just make a couple of those. I'll have to fill that up. Yeah, let me get some preparations done, guys, and I will be back in just a little bit. All right, guys, I am back, and I think I have finished all of my preparations. I should probably just double-check and make sure. I've got item, I've got power. Okay, I should have everything I need. Ooh, actually, I need some redstone. Just in case, we'll take about a stack. That's probably more than I need. And then I need an angel block, which looks like this. Just need one of those, and that should do the trick. So, now that that's finished, I believe it is time for us to head to the end, which is somewhere, let's see, over this way, way off to the east. So I'm going to head off that way, guys. I'm going to get into the end, and I will see you in just a little bit. All right, guys, we are here in the end. So let's take a look at the map. This is the general end area. I think we'll fly off to the west for a pretty good ways. We're gonna go, let's see, so I think if we go to about, let's go to maybe Y400 or so, or X400 or so. I think that will be quite far enough. Yeah, somewhere right about here. That's a pretty good distance. That should be out of spawn range for the main ender area. So, what we're going to do out here, we'll go even a little bit farther, because why not? We'll go to like 550-ish. That'll work. Okay, so what we're going to do out here is we're going to build ourselves an Enderman farm. And we're going to lay down that angel block. And what's nice about the angel block is you can place it on absolutely anything. which is fantastic and very much needed. Now we'll grab our chisel. Let's put this stuff... purple backpack. Let's just take out a bunch of this stone. And the first thing we're going to want to do is pick out a texture for our stone. And I'm kind of thinking... polished stone brick. Ooh, fancy. What's this look like? That actually works pretty well, I think. I'm pretty happy with that, honestly. I think that'll do just fine. Let's go grab our magnet, because we want to be able to make sure we pick up, like, this angel block when it falls. There we go. Actually, the angel block, if I remember correctly, it automatically ends up in your inventory. Now, the next thing we want to do is make sure that we're building within a single chunk. And it looks like it's a good thing we check, because we are right up against this one. So, what we're going to do is go ahead, and this is going to be our boundary. We're essentially going to fill in this whole chunk with this stone right up against the border, and that way we can just tell where it is. So we'll do that. There we go. So that is our chunk that we're working in. Now, let's go ahead and make a few more of these. Oh, that's not the right one. It's this lighter colored. There we go. Let's just make a few of those. Like so. And, oh, Builder's Wand's already in our inventory. Awesome. And we'll just go ahead and lay all of that down. Like that. I don't suppose I can reach that from here, can I? No, of course not. That's all right. Reach it from over here instead. Okay. So, that gives us this nice big old platform in the end, which is excellent. Exactly one chunk. So, we're in good shape there. Now, the next thing that I'm going to want to do is build a couple more of these platforms. Essentially, it's going to be a drop farm. I do need to know if... ooh, these cloud blocks are going to be in the way. Okay, can I break them? Are they breakable? They are. Ooh, this... I didn't think about that. Maybe there's a better tool? Will, like, a shovel get rid of them faster? Not really. Oh, man. This could take a while, because we don't want the Enderman getting stuck on this. Oh boy. Well, that's proof that this is going to work, so that's good. Oh, man. That's all right. All right, guys, let me get some work done on this farm, and I'll be back with you in just a little bit. All right, guys, I am back, and I've got basically the design for the farm figured out. I got rid of all the clouds, and the way that this works is each platform will look something like this. Now, we won't have Endermen spawning up here normally, but each platform will look like this. There are fans. These four fans blow out, and these four fans blow to right in front of the other fans. So the Enderman will fall, get knocked off, and land way down there, where they will be killed by fall damage. So that is essentially the plan. Now, I can't remember if Endermen need a 3-high or a 4-high space to spawn, so I'm going to play it safe, and I'm going to go 4-high. So let's make another layer to this, just like so. And then we want room for our fans. Actually, let's see. This would be 3 layers, right? Yeah. So we want actually to build this up one more like that. And then this would be our next floor layer right here. So we'll take that and go. Just like, oh, that's not what I wanted to do. And because of the fans, that is naturally going to be a huge pain to clean up. There we go. Be careful with the builder's wand, because if you don't, it can definitely come back to bite you. So this is one spawning platform. Now we can go ahead and do the next one. So let's go like this. And these are where the fans will go. Now, something that I learned is that these chiseled blocks, for whatever reason, cannot be powered. I don't know why that is, but for redstone, specifically for the levers that power the fans, it has to be some sort of a block that can accept power. So we're just going to use regular old smooth stone right here where the fans can go. This one's got to be taken out as well. There we go. And then we can go ahead and put our levers on there right away, just like that. There we go. Now, right behind those, we'll go ahead and take a row of these just like this. And that kind of forms the basis for where our fans are all going to go now. So we can go ahead and bring that up. 4 high, I believe, is what we're doing. That seems to make the most sense anyway. There we go. Oh, and I was standing in that one. So we'll do that. And then manually, we can come here and do this. And I think, I don't know how many spawning platforms we're going to use. I'm thinking maybe, let's see, where do we have for build limit? Maybe like 4, 1, 2, maybe 4 or 5. And it's a design that would be pretty easy to replicate, so maybe we'll start with 4 or 5, and then we can go ahead, and if we need to, we can expand it even more. So that might be the best course of action. Let's fill that in. And builder's wand across like that. There we go. So 2 levels. And you guys get the idea, I think, at least. I hope so. I hope you guys understand what I'm doing here. Let's go ahead and do just one more on camera, just to be on the safe side. And then the rest of them I will do off camera. The remaining layers, because I don't feel the need to show you the same thing 7 times or 5 times or however many times we're actually going to make these platforms. So, smooth stone there. Like so. Put the levers on the back to power the fans. Bring that around. And I do have to give credit to Brink the Gamer from StudTech for the idea for this, because he did an Enderman farm that was kind of similar to this in StudTech, and that's where I got the idea. So I should probably give credit where credit is due. Just a thought. There we go. So that looks pretty good. And now we just need to builder's wand that up so that it is like that. Actually, just kidding. I think that's incorrect. I think I went 1 too high there. Yeah, because that's 4. Okay. Sweet. We'll do that. And then we'll go ahead and bring this one up as well. There we go. And finally, fill in those blocks to keep anything from spawning above the fans. So we've got that going. There, fan, 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 and bam. So that's what our Enderman farm is going to look like. I'm going to go ahead and knock out a couple more levels, guys, and I will be back in just a little bit. All right, guys, I am back. We've got 5 levels done, which I think should be more than enough. So now we're going to go ahead and slab the top of it just to keep things from spawning up here. And you know what? I don't know why I'm doing it with by hand. I've got this builder's wand that would make this go not as fast as I thought it would. It seems I'm out of half slabs. There we go. Let's make a bunch more. Like so. Beautiful. Now we should be able to slab off the rest. Good. Okay. So, let's take a look at it. Pretty impressive, I think. And should generate a lot of mob spawn since this is the only place where stuff can spawn. So now we need to go through and flip all the levers, which should turn on all the fans up here. Yes, it does. Good, good, good. We'll get those all going. And that looks pretty good, I think. Yeah, that's not too bad. This one I think I'm going to tweak a little bit just so that it kind of matches up with the rest. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I didn't do these blocks over here, which I'm going to add just for the sake of symmetry. But all of our fans should now be going. So now we need to work on a collection area. And I know that the area directly underneath the mob farm will be safe. Look at that. We're already getting stuff falling. This is awesome. So, collection area. Let's see. I think I'm almost worried that they're going to be able to fall too far. So it might be a good idea to actually put a wall over here that goes up and that would basically just prevent them from falling to their death. I think that would probably be wise on my part. I also think we might just run out of stone. So let's bring this up a ways. I don't know just how high. Well, we might even have to bring it up the entire way. That would be kind of unfortunate. Oh, yep. And just like that, I am indeed out of stone. So I think I'm going to make a trip back, guys. Grab some more supplies. Although, actually, do I have any more in here? 4 stacks. That's not going to be enough. That's probably not going to be enough, but it'll be enough to at least get a pretty good start on this. There we go. So what we'll do is build this up a ways. Just want to make sure I'm standing right on top of it. Keep anything from accidentally spawning. And I think, are any of them actually reaching over this far? It doesn't seem like it. We'll bring it up a few more layers just to be safe. But I think that should be a big enough wall. So now, the next step, as I said, is the collection area. We know that they're all gonna fall somewhere right about here or so. So what we can do, let me turn down hostile creatures. There we go. So what we can do now is we can start laying down our hoppers. And the way that I want to do this, Let's see, we got a chunk loader. Oh, you know what? I think that they might actually need to feed into a chest. Now that I think about this. That's all right, we can make a chest. That's not that big of a deal. Let's put you over here. Let's just make a chest right there. And we're gonna put that maybe right about here or so. But I want to build it up a little ways. I want to make sure... Oh, and you guys. Sorry, but you guys need to go. Get off my platform. Let's half slab this so nothing can spawn up here. There we go. That's better. Okay. Why so angry? Go away. Anyway, we'll put our chest here. And then we'll take out those, and that way we can essentially feed all of our hoppers into this chest. And hopefully this will work fairly well without causing insane amounts of lag. So let's just bring maybe about, yeah, right about there. That should probably work. We'll bring this line back. And then we'll just bring these all the way over. Which admittedly is going to take a pretty long time. So let me get these hoppers all filled in, guys, and I'll be back in just a little bit. All right, guys, I am back, and we have just enough hoppers. So basically, this center row... all the hoppers ultimately feed into this chest, which is pretty awesome. And that's exactly what I want. And yes, I know that this is almost definitely not the most resource-efficient way to do this, but sometimes it's fun to kind of do stuff with vanilla mechanics, because we don't really always get the opportunity to do that as much as we might like. So, now the next thing that we need to do is start wiring this stuff up. So, first and foremost, I'm going to take an item conduit coming out of this chest, just like so. We'll get rid... Ooh, I want to be able to see them all. There we go. We'll get rid of that. And this will feed out of here. So, extract. For now, we're just going to say never active. And now, we need to feed these into a couple different things. So I'm going to take two deep storage units, and I'm going to take a... Did I not bring... Ah, there it is. We're going to take two deep storage units and two item filters. I'm going to need an Enderman head, an Enderman pearl. There we go. And we'll go... let's see here. This is the center. So I think what we'll do is right here, and we can put slabs underneath. You are that, and you are this. And that should work, so that basically only... Enderman heads and Ender pearls can end up in there. I don't know that you can actually get Enderman heads doing it this way, but I do want to just be on the safe side. So this is going to be insert priority one, insert priority one, and we actually need to put you in here. I might need to go and get my hands on another Enderman head. Nope, never mind. Good to go. And, well, Ender Pearls I've got tons of. So, Ender Pearl. Whitelist. Okay. And you, Enderman head. Okay. Should be good. So now, if I take this to extract and go to always active, And then we'll go into this backpack, or maybe it's... Which backpack is it? This one. I got a bunch of speed upgrades, so we can take those, and those should suck those out pretty quick. Ender pearls ending up in here, and this Enderman Vita, which we don't want, is staying away, and that is good. That's what we want. Okay, now I'm going to put another slab here, and I'm going to put the trash can on top of it, and I'm going to say insert priority 0, and that would be basically anything else that isn't an Enderman head or an Ender pearl. So that should work out pretty well. Now, the next thing to do, or you know what, we could probably even compact that further. Let's grab our Tesseract. I mean, ultimately, you're never actually going to come to this farm, except for maintenance anyway, so it's not really the kind of farm that needs to look all that amazingly impressive. So maybe we'll just leave it be. But we'll go like this. We'll say, actually, you know what? It would be way better for us to do this instead. Yeah. Let's actually plan to feed this stuff that would be going into the Tesseract. Let's actually plan to feed that directly into here. So we're going to take our Enderman head item filter. We'll grab one of those. We'll grab an Ender Pearl. This is insert priority plus 2 item filter. One of those, and one of those. And that should then still take these out. And we shouldn't see any more Ender Pearls going in here. But if we go to extract, and actually I can take that item filter too. Extract, always active. Extract, always active. These should start draining. And now we need to set this to wireless power and go energy receive item mode send and fluid blocked. So that will now start drawing power and all that kind of good stuff directly into the ME system, which is good. That's what we want. We can get rid of these all together. And where's my pick? There it is. And then all we need to do is basically re-slab this floor. And right next to this thing, we need to put a chunk loader to make sure that this is actually loading this chunk at pretty much all times. And that should pretty much do it. That gives us an Enderman farm, huge amounts of Ender Pearls. Those will all be fed in here. This will be running constantly, and it should do the trick quite nicely. So guys, I think I'm going to go ahead and end this episode right here. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it, and it really helps out my channel. I think in some future episode, we'll probably come back here and clean this place up to make it look a little bit more presentable. But for now, I'm fine with it. So, guys, you can find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. Links in the video description below, so check that out as well. But other than that, guys, thanks for watching, and we'll definitely see you next time.